Hi, in this tutorial, I'll show you how Wrap lets you automatically create previews for a large number of facial expression scans without using any external software. Imagine you have 40 scans of an actor's face and need to preview them all. You can do so without opening each one manually. That saves a lot of time. First, let's save our project in the folder where all our files are located. Name it Compositing in Wrap and set the version. Later, we'll be able to use Project Dire, which is very convenient. For this example, we've scanned 40 facial expressions and stored them in a folder. We'll select all the files, drag them into Wrap, and load them as a sequence. You'll need to wait a bit. It'll depend on the model size. Okay, once loaded, we turn off the wireframe. This is our model. Let's rename this node to Scans. Each scan is about 50 megabytes in size, so checking them one by one manually takes time. That's why we'll generate automatic previews. You can quickly scroll through the images and make sure that everything looks correct. To do this, we'll set up a camera and render each frame. Pick a suitable view. I'll choose the front. Copy it from the viewport by clicking Copy from Main Camera. We disable Lock Aspect Ratio. Set a resolution, for example, 900 by 1080. Then we add a render node. We connect the current scan to the first input, the camera to the second input. Now everything's set and we can start working with the image. We switch to the 2D viewport, which shows us what the camera sees. In the render node, I'll go with transparent background. When we switch between frames, we can see our scans rendered as images. It would be useful to label each image clearly. So for that, we use the text image node. Reduce the text size. Let's move the text down by clicking this button, then raise it slightly. It's okay. We want the name of each scan to appear automatically. Now we know how to substitute static text, but we want it to display the name of the current expression. So we can add dynamic text in this field. Click the button, open the Python editor window. We'll be managing files, so we need a library to handle paths. I'll import the OS module. In file name, we'll copy the names of the files that we loaded into our project at the beginning. When we start typing the node name, a list of nodes appear. We press Enter to choose the right one and select the needed parameter. We use Return to check the result. Press Run or F5. We see the full path, but we only need the name. So we apply the base name function. Return again. Now we see the file name with the OBJ extension. Then we use the split text to remove the extension and keep just the name. Now let's take a look at the result. When switching frames, we now see each scan's name appear dynamically in the image. So that part is done, but let's improve it. Sometimes we want to see just the geometry to check for artifacts, but other times we need to evaluate the scans with the texture applied. It would be great to show both with and without textures on the same image. We'll do that. First, we create a background using the Create Image node. We'll use the default Full HD resolution. Let's assign a background color. I'll select this one. Then, we merge our scan image on top using Merge Image. Background goes into input 1, and the scan with label goes into input 2. Now we have more space. Let's adjust its position on the x-axis. You can see that instead of the checkerboard in the background, there's now a gray color. So we want to render the texture version. Textures are in this folder. Drag them into Wrap. Load them as a sequence as well. This is what it looks like. Let's apply our texture to the geometry using the Set Texture node. Choose Textures to input 1 and Geometry to input 2. We press Q to switch to the 3D viewport and confirm the textures are mapped correctly. Next, copy the render node and connect it to the textured scan. Let's press W to switch back to the 2D viewport. Then we use another Merge Image node to combine both renders, untextured version into input 1, textured version into input 2. Offset the textured image along the x-axis. Okay, After joining the two images, we need to change the position of the text. Connect the render node directly to the merge. Place the text image node below the others. Each image shows geometry both with and without textures. As we switch frames, we get updated scans and file names. Now let's save our images using the Save Image node. Instead of saving each preview manually, we'll use a small script to export all the images at once. We want each image to be named like the scan. We'll reuse part of the code we wrote earlier in the Text Image node. Just copy it from there. Paste it into the Python expression field of Save Image. Make sure that everything was copied correctly. We just press F5 to check it. Let's rewrite this line. This time, we'll add .jpg to the name. Press F5. Now our files are in the correct format. We merge the folder path with the file name using join. I'll use the project dir. This is the path to the folder where my project was saved. Add the images folder and DST name. We see the full path appears correctly. We switch between a few frames just to confirm that everything works correctly. Then we'll click compute frame range. Set the range from 0 to 39. Choose the number of threads. I'll pick 6. Then click the start button. Each scan is around 50 megabytes, so the process will take some time. After it finishes, all images appear in the folder. A preview of your scans, each labeled nicely. That's the end of this tutorial. We learned how to quickly work with large scan batches in Wrap, automatically label them, and generate previews that let us compare geometry with and without textures all in one image. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.